Yeah, interesting you say that on travel. I mean, we're about to hit the European summer season where everybody jets off to Europe. So you'd have to think with a few more bucks in your pocket from July 1, that spending is going to continue.
Yeah, and then the other thing that's going on right now is that despite what we talk about with you and me about where the Aussie dollar sits at 66.5 US cents to the Aussie dollar, against other currencies, the Aussie is one of, if not the best performing currency in the G10. So if you look at it against the euro, you look at it against the pound, you look at it particularly against the yen, the attractiveness of overseas travel to those destinations, but also the attractiveness of those products coming into our country, keeps spending up because they appear cheap to us here in Australia. And that's, I think, also been lost in this debate, particularly Japanese exports. They are incredibly cheap. So if you look at things like brown goods, white goods, they are actually seeing a reasonable amount of sales. Most of them come out of Japan because the yen is so cheap. So all of that filters into that debate that we're having here is that inflation is holding at around 3.5%. And as I said, for the last 3 months, it's actually ticked up. It's sitting at 3.6. So the data to watch around your interest rate question is next month's numbers and whether or not it holds or goes up again.
Okay. Evan Lucas, appreciate that. Thank you.